My name is Conrad Labandeira, and I'm a paleoecologist at the Smithsonian Institution's National Museum of Natural History.
Right now, we're in the Karoo Basin here in South Africa. The goal for today is to collect fossils.
To really understand the Permian-Triassic extinction and the events that occurred before it and after it. The End-Permian crisis is one of the most amazing parts in the history of life because it represents the most serious challenge to the continuation of life on this planet.
So we're trying to reconstruct what this community of life looked like. And we're trying to reconstruct a food web. The plants, the insects that ate the plants, the vertebrates that ate the insects. And eventually we're going to compare this food web with the food web that came after and see how ecosystems have changed through time. And so in many ways it's kind of like what a detective does. We look for clues and evidence, and then we try to come up with an understanding of what this evidence signifies. And that, to me, is really what we do. That's my job. And it is the best job in the world.
I'm Rose Previk, and I'm a paleobotanist. I study the plants, particularly, not so much the animals. And together with Dr. Labandeira, we're trying to look at how insects fitted into this picture by looking at damage that occurred on the leaves.
Oh, look at this.
Ah, beautiful margin feeding.
Yeah.
And it's got a slightly jaggedy edge where the insect perhaps avoided some of the tougher material in the leaf.
Insect feeding behavior established in the past continues today.
Here we have margin feeding, and this kind of damage is very informative because it says something about how insects and the plants are relating to one another. And what we have here is something that's happening in the here and now. But what I look at in the fossil record is something that's happening in the deep past.
Gosh, there must be about 50 leaves on this thing.
This is the most fun that you can have. It's awesome. Every time you open the rock, you know, it's something no one's ever seen before.
When you find that evidence, it's a thrilling event. Because all your patience, all your perseverance becomes rewarded. Oh, fantastic.
Some sort of surface abrasion.
That's really a minor part of it. The major part is what comes after. We take that evidence back to the lab and then analyze it.
So that we can understand the patterns in which the insect herbivores are feeding on the plant hosts. So here's the margin of the leaf, the cut, the end of the cut, and the margin of the leaf resumes again.
1B.
Uh-huh.
1A.
We're recording all of the plant species to a database. And we're also documenting kinds of damage by insect herbivores on these plants. And in this particular site, one of the unique results that we observe is very little plant diversity, but highly elevated insect consumption of those plants, both in terms of the diversity of plant damage and in the frequency of plant damage.
I don't know what these things are. Maybe could these be the stuff?
So in order to really understand that further, one of the avenues of research that we would like to investigate is to see whether or not this phenomenon is more common throughout the fossil record in major crises in the history of land life. And that has implications for what's happening today in terms of global climatic change. So in my view, these are very interesting questions, and they provide answers to things that I think a lot of us want to know, but haven't been able to address.